Over 2,000 years ago, as China was first united by Emperor Qin Shi Huang, a vast trading network was controlled by a widowed merchant woman. The grand historian Sima Qian said that the emperor respected her for her chastity. But there must have been something else to their relationship, something that held the emperor and the widow in a common bond.
Chongqing 现在的话发现的 有明显的单砂痕迹的，就是10年的时候，我们在涪陵发现过一座墓葬，它的等级还比较高，是属于那个西汉时期的。它的墓葬里面有很多单砂，我们当时就采集了一些样品，可能都有那个1000克多。然后当地有一些民风民俗，可能作为啊这个单砂可能是一种财富或者一种宗教上方面的象征，然后把它随葬到那个墓葬里面。 当时巴钦家族，他掌握了那种，就是比较先进的那个提炼手段的话，和开他首先是他有地理条件，他占据了那个蕴藏量特别丰富的矿山。其次，他又掌握了比较先进的那个提炼技术的话，他当时属于全国垄断的地位的话，当时那个单砂又是属于一种那种，就是大家比较认同的，然后因为单砂的作用很多，它可以入药。
In ancient Chinese belief, cinnabar was analogous to blood, which gave it the power to drive away evil spirits. Its ability to be magically transformed from blood-red earth to the silvery liquid mercury gave it further symbolic power.
人活着的时候，血是鲜红的；人死了过后，血就变黑了。 好，单砂矿是红颜色的，所以把这个，把单砂矿啊，把那个单砂呢，用来放到死者的身边，它有希望死者起死回生，有这么一个追求在里边。另外呢，后来人们通过观察呢，就发现，单砂呢还有一个作用，它能够让尸体不腐烂。好，古代的中国人呢，有这么一个，有这么一种意识。 认为人的肉体跟灵魂是两码事，好，人死了过后是灵魂暂时的离开了这个肉体，如果能够保住这个肉体不腐烂，灵魂还可以回来，还可以起死回生。
Both mercury and cinnabar have strong antibacterial and disinfectant qualities. They are both also highly toxic to humans. But without this scientific knowledge, the ancient Chinese believed that cinnabar could be the secret to eternal life. Emperor Qin Shi Huang's mausoleum was built at the foot of Li Mountain at Lin Tong in Xi'an. In the early 1980s, researchers surveying the site found that the mercury levels in the soil of the tomb mound were up to 100 times higher than normal. This would seem to support Sima Qian's description of the tomb as containing a model of the emperor's domains with the rivers made from mercury.
This water is not from the wind itself, but from a sieve gong. This means that this gong is from the earth's gong. From the gong, the water is released. 随着土壤的缝隙，然后呢，上升传到这个风土里边的。Mercury,
a liquid metal at normal temperatures, it's volatile and vaporizes easily. This has always made it a health hazard to those who work with the liquid. The emperor spent 38 years building his great underground necropolis. After finally uniting his empire, he was able to devote even more resources to the tomb's construction. It's estimated he used around 100 tons of mercury.
后来秦始皇修筑万历长城，要权贵捐资，这个是聚财，或者是拉丁呢筹夫。他得到个消息过后，就毅然地提供了大量的白银，他的资产不可计数，大量的白银。后来秦始皇要修建他的秦陵墓，又需要水银，又提供了大量的水银。
Or at least postponing death. Cinnabar, a remedy for all diseases of internal organs, nurtures the spirit, calms the soul, and kills all demons and evils. Its long-term usage will result in immortality and the ability to connect with gods. So reads the oldest Chinese pharmacological compendium from the 2nd century. The ancient Chinese discovered that when cinnabar is heated in the current of air, the condensed vapor yields mercury, and when mercury is heated with cinnabar, it returns to its original form. The seemingly magical cycle made it appear like cinnabar held the key to understanding life, the universe, and everything. Tao Hong Jing, a Taoist scholar and alchemist, wrote in the 5th century, "Cinnabar is the essence to all psychic concoctions, a treasure to make men immortal."
丹砂，它是在中国，它是一个很重要的养生的药品。在历史上，我们说丹砂就是不死之药。中国历代很多皇帝啊，他们倾其所有到处寻找什么？寻找不死之药。 是长了一个马眼睛，长长的、鼓鼓的，是吧？马眼睛，然后治疗因就是我们说的鸡胸。从这几个体态特征来看，秦始皇虽然贵为始皇帝，但是他的身体条件不大好。
Poor health made the emperor even more desperate for the fabled elixir. The secret of immortality was often believed to reside with ancient mountain hermits. One scholar suggested the emperor himself live as a recluse in order to find it. The emperor was far from being alone in believing such a thing was possible. To pander to his concerns, some told the emperor about the mythical islands in the Eastern Ocean where immortal herbs could be found. In 219 BC, the emperor sent his envoy, Xu Fu, on a voyage with 1,000 virgin boys and girls in search of the magical herb. They never returned. To have returned unsuccessful would undoubtedly be a sentence of death. By legend, they settled in Japan. The closest the emperor now could be sure he could get to the secret was someone who knew all about cinnabar.
Because 八卦符，拆三年狂，这个狂来讲呢，它的年的结构就是水印，水印呢，经过一定的冶炼提炼，就会炼成一种叫做丹药。 丹药这个丹药可以治病，可以防腐，这就为以后秦始皇的最是长生不老之仙丹丹药提供了物质条件和冶炼技术，冶炼技术。因此，秦始皇到处寻丹长生不老，只有与八卦符亲自有关系。
Drug taking to try to extend life seems to have been a common practice from the earliest days of the empire. The symptoms of heavy metal poisoning, hallucinations, and feelings of bodily lightness were, for some, a proof that the elixir was working. The book composed for a prince in 120 BC describes a recipe of pills made from mercury, cinnabar, and realgar. It's not known whether the prince would have actually tried them himself.
丹砂呢，作为一种中药呢，《李时珍的本草纲目》里边有记载，主要的说，它能够治五脏的白病。 能够养精神，能够养神，安神安魂，还有能够杀毒，当时说的很多，但是这个东西呢，它是有毒的，虽然这个李时珍的《本草纲目》说它没有毒，但是它是有毒的，如果这个超过了一定的量，它就会有副作用，中国历史上。 因为服食丹药发生的悲剧很多很多，大概就是超越了那个量。
Xu Huang's time, with no knowledge of its dangers, its consumption was widespread among those wealthy enough to afford it. However, there may have been something else behind the emperor's relationship with Ba Qian. Sima Qian, in his historical records, described her as being a chaste woman, but the title at that time could have another meaning.
So, the 贞字 的本来含义，第一层，贞者正也，就是一个正大的、不可侵犯的这么样一个女性，这算一个解释。第二，这个贞呢，你看这个字的本来的含义，它上面是一个占卜的卜，下面是一个宝贝的贝。其实这个字《说文》里头讲得很清楚，是吧？贞者，卜问也，就是占卜问吉凶。好了，贞卜问也，这是谁？什么样的人才能做这样的工作呢？
In the Shang and Zhou dynasties, a chaste man usually referred to a mage or fortune teller who could communicate with the gods, divining answers to questions and also treatments for the sick. The careful choice of words used by Sima Qian could well imply the same thing. Not only was Ba Qing the source of the cinnabar and mercury that the emperor needed, she also acted as a personal oracle or even alchemist to the emperor. She was responsible for concocting the vital elixir itself.
北方叫真人，南方就叫巫，真者巫也。所以说，这个真字透露出一个信息，八卦父亲有可能是巫。也就是说，他有可能是医生。
In ancient China, diviners were responsible for many different areas of life. They not only led religious ceremonies and practiced their divination to determine the best course for future actions, they also predicted illness and possible treatments, as well as serving as teachers and mentors.
人们在自然面前呢，因为生产力相对低下一些，他更感觉一种束手无能为力的这种情况，所以呢，他就是借助要需要有这种强烈的需求，借助神灵的力量来改变他的现实的状况。所以呢，这个巫文化只是在北方的时候进入了文明时代，然后巫文化呢，它还在南方呢长久地保留下来。
In ancient times, oracles, sorcerers, and doctors often overlapped. In the traditional Chinese, the character for doctor is based on that for sorcerer.
他是不是巫，我们搞不清楚。我们刚才说的巫医同源，但是没有说他是医生。但他那个既然在开采丹砂、提炼丹砂呢，有可能，如果推测的话，有可能他懂。啊，当然从这个角度来看，也可以说他懂跟那个巫也要沾边的。
In fact, local folklore describes Qing's husband's ancestor, who found the cinnabar mine, as being a doctor or herbalist. 。The cinnabar mines were mostly found in the southeast Sichuan area.Where the culture of the magicians originated and thrived. The nearby Mount Wu, meaning Sorcerer's Mountain in Chinese, was also known as the Spirit Mountain. This region of the Three Gorges was Ba Qing's homeland.
所以八卦父亲实际上他是一个巫。巫就是一个什么带有神话的那种人，他往往被人神化，就说他是一个有神性的女性，所以他的地位就非同寻常。
This could explain how a widow from a remote county was able to gain such favor from the emperor himself.The semi-divine status of a priestess might grant her the power to live beyond the laws applied to others.
因为在古代的时候呢，当人们有生老病死的时候呢，他首先呢，他要寻求一种方法，然后治愈他的这种疾患。那么在这个时候呢，因为巫师呢，他是最高级的知识分子，他可能呢掌握了一些这种草药的这种技术，对一些植物的这种药性呢，他会比平常人呢他多一些认识，所以呢他也会利用这种丹砂，利用一些民间的草药，然后呢给这些老百姓治病。那么他的这种效率呢，总比肯定会比你等死这种听天由命要强。所以呢，他在人们心目中呢，他能就拥有一定的地位。
So the emperor would have relied on Ba Qing for her supplies of cinnabar and her knowledge of how to use it to make his so desperately desired elixir of immortality. And when that elixir began to damage his health, he would probably have looked to her for a cure too. But the political and military importance of the Ba region could not be ignored either. Trouble down there could lead to serious problems for the emperor.
他为什么要扶持？一个从战略上考虑，这个大家族是我打楚国的重要的依靠力量。就是他经营的丹砂，跟人类的健康长寿有关系，跟秦国的统一大业有关系。所以综合起来，秦国的历朝君王会重视巴渝地区那些豪强大族，反过来豪强大族也要需要这样一种政治力量来给他支持，作为他的。
The widow Ba Qing was truly the sorceress who had the power to make the elixir of immortality and communicate with the gods. What role did she play in Emperor Qin Shi Huang's wars with his rivals? Please join us for part 4 of The Mystery of the Cinnabar Queen.